गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, माई टॉपिक टूडे इज सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी. सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी प्रिंसिपल आर्टरी विच कंटिन्यूज एज एक्सिलरी आर्टरी फॉर द अपर लिम, ऑल्सो सप्लाइज नेक एंड ब्रेन. ओरिजिन ऑन द राइट साइड, इट इज ब्रांच ऑफ ब्रेकियोसिफेलिक आर्टरी. इट अराइजेज पोस्टीरियर टू द स्टर्नोक्लेविकुलर जॉइंट. ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड इट इज ब्रांच ऑफ आर्च ऑफ aorta. It ascend and enter the neck posterior to the left sternoclavicular joint. Course of subclavian artery. Each artery arches laterally from the sternoclavicular joint to outer border of first rib, where it ends by becoming continuous with the axillary artery. Scalenus anterior muscle crosses the artery anteriorly and divide it into three parts. So in this diagram we can see origin and course of subclavian artery. This is arch of aorta, brachiocephalic, right subclavian, left subclavian, right and left common carotid. Scalenus anterior muscle crosses the artery anteriorly and divides it into first, second and third part. First part medial to muscle, second part posterior to muscle, and third part lateral to scalenus anterior muscle. Now, relations of first, second, and third part of subclavian artery. Relations. First part related anteriorly with common carotid artery, vagus, internal jugular vein, sterno hyoid, sternocleidomastoid. Posteriorly related with suprapleural membrane, cervical pleura, apex of lung. Relations of second part of subclavian artery anteriorly, scalenus anterior, sternocleidomastoid, right phrenic nerve due to the prevertebral fascia. Posteriorly, suprapleural membrane, cervical pleura, apex of lung. Superiorly, upper and middle trunk of brachial plexus. Third part related anteriorly with middle half of clavicle, posterior border of sternocleidomastoid. Posteriorly related with scalenus medius, lower trunk of brachial plexus, suprapleural membrane, apex of lung. Superiorly, upper and middle trunk of brachial plexus, and inferiorly, first rib. Now, branches of subclavian artery. In this diagram, we can see this one is subclavian, apex of lung, cervical pleura, and from subclavian artery arises vertebral, internal thoracic, thyrocervical, costocervical trunk. So number one branch is vertebral artery, number two internal thoracic, number three thyrocervical trunk, costocervical trunk number four, and sometime occasionally dorsal scapular artery. Thyrocervical trunk, which divides into three branches: inferior thyroid, suprascapular, transverse cervical. And costocervical trunk divides into two branches: superior intercostal and deep cervical arteries. So in this diagram we can see different branches of subclavian artery. Now branches in detail. Branches of subclavian. Number one is vertebral artery. Vertebral artery, first and largest branch of the first part of subclavian artery. It runs a long course and ends in the cranial cavity by supplying the brain. It is divided into four parts. The first part extends from its origin to the foramen transverse ilium of the sixth cervical vertebrae. This part runs upward, backward into the angle between scalenus anterior and the longus coli muscle behind the common carotid artery, the vertebral vein, and the inferior thyroid artery. In this diagram, again we can see this one is subclavian. This one is vertebral. Scalenus anterior, longus coli. This one is vertebral artery, thyrocervical trunk, internal thoracic artery. So next is internal thoracic artery. Arises from inferior aspect of first part of subclavian artery opposite to origin of thyrocervical trunk. The origin lies near the medial border of scalenus anterior. The artery runs downward medially in front of cervical pleura. Anteriorly, the artery is related to sternal end of clavicle. The artery enters the thorax by passing behind the first costal cartilage. It runs till 6th intercostal space, where it ends by dividing into superior epigastric and musculophrenic arteries. Next branch of subclavian artery is thyrocervical trunk. Thyrocervical trunk, short wide vessel which arises from the front of first part of subclavian artery close to the medial border of scalenus anterior and between phrenic and vagus nerves. It divides into inferior thyroid, transverse cervical, and suprascapular arteries. Inferior thyroid artery. So, number one, this one is inferior thyroid. Inferior thyroid, it gives glandular branches to thyroid, and it gives ascending cervical artery, runs upward in front of transverse process of cervical vertebra. The inferior laryngeal artery, which accompanies the recurrent laryngeal nerve and enters the larynx deep to the lower border of inferior constrictor, and other branches which supply the pharynx, trachea, esophagus, and surrounding muscles. Now next is suprascapular artery. Suprascapular runs laterally downwards and crosses the scalenus anterior and phrenic nerve. It lies behind the internal jugular vein and the sternocleidomastoid. It then crosses the trunk of brachial plexus and runs in the posterior triangle behind and parallel with the clavicle to reach the superior border of scapula. It crosses above the suprascapular ligament and takes part in the anastomosis around the scapula. In addition to branches to surrounding muscle, the artery also supplies the clavicle, scapula, shoulder, and acromioclavicular joint. Next is transverse cervical artery. Transverse cervical runs laterally above the suprascapular artery. It crosses the scalenus anterior and phrenic nerve, passing behind the internal jugular vein and the sternocleidomastoid. It then crosses the brachial plexus and the floor of posterior triangle to reach the anterior border of trapezius, where it divides into superficial and deep branches. Superficial branch accompanies the spinal root of accessory nerve till the lower end of muscle. The deep branch passes deep to levator scapulae and takes part in anastomosis around the scapula. Now next is dorsal scapular artery and costocervical trunk. Dorsal scapular artery arrives occasionally from the third part of subclavian artery. If transverse cervical does not divide into superficial and deep branches but continues as superficial branch, the distribution of deep branch is taken over by dorsal scapular artery. Costocervical trunk. Costocervical trunk arises from the posterior surface of the second part of subclavian artery on the right side. goes to cervical trunk. But from the first part of artery on the left side, it arches backwards over the cervical pleura, divides into descending superior intercostal and ascending deep cervical arteries at the neck of first rib. Superior intercostal artery descend in front of the neck of first rib and divides into first and second posterior intercostal arteries. Deep cervical artery analogous to the posterior branch of a posterior intercostal artery. It passes backwards between the transverse process of 7 cervical vertebrae and the neck of first rib. It then ascends between the semispinalis capitis and cervicis up to the axis vertebra. It anastomoses with the occipital and vertebral arteries. Now,